What's up? My goal today is to introduce you to the most important and intriguing beings from the Japanese mythology.
Just give me 30 seconds to give you a quick overview on the entire system and the different types of beings we'll encounter today, alright?
The whole Japanese mythology is closely connected to the religion Shinto, which focuses on various rituals on your way to becoming a pure human. The two of the most important types of beings are kami and yokai. Kami are like the deities, or more accurately, spirits, representing anything you can imagine. Yokai are pretty similar, but are described as monsters and possess an animalistic figure. The two founding gods are called Izanagi and Izanami.
Now that we're on the same page, let's start exploring the individual beings then.
Let's start with Amaterasu. She's one of the main kami, representing the sun, and sometimes even the wind, or death, or even the whole Japanese ethnicity. She's believed to be the ancestor of the rulers of Japan. The list of important gods cannot omit Fujin and Reijin. The first one is the god of the wind, portrayed as a green-skinned humanoid demon. Along with his brother Reijin, the god of thunder and storm, they escaped the Japanese underworld, Yomi, through a crack in the boulder which Izanagi used to block the entrance.
Yeah, he tried rescuing Izanami from there, but was unable to. Sad story, really.
Anyway, Raiju is a wolf covered in lightning, often accompanying Raijin.
And I just can't think of any other creature whose name sounds like Raiju and is associated with lightning. Nothing comes to mind. It's a cool name. Somebody should use it in a game or something.
Also, Tsukuyomi is the moon god, but we don't even know their gender, so I don't know how to address them. Yeah, we just don't know a lot about this kami. Hanako-san is a girl who haunts toilets in schools because she most probably committed suicide in one. Yeah. Similarly, Teke Teke haunts train stations at night because she was pushed by her bullies on a railway line and got cut in half by a train.
Man, Japan has to chill with the vengeful spirits. There's more of them than The Witcher.
Zenyo Ryuo is the god of the rain, represented by a dragon and a woman combined.
Their combo moves must be insane!
Bake Kujira is a big-ass skeleton whale that supposedly brings misfortune to people. Ikuchi is a weird fish that's a few kilometers in length and, let's just say, isn't too friendly to the fishermen. Mizuchi is a goddamn water dragon.
I want one, okay?
And Namazu is a literal catfish, and it's giant, and it causes earthquakes. So now you know who to blame for them. Also, the Pokemon Whiskash is called Namazoon in the Japanese version. I see the resemblance, but okay, I'm done with the water creatures, oh man. So in other news, Sun Wukong is a monkey-like creature from the 16th century Chinese novel Journey to the West, but what's important is that it's sometimes called Son Goku.
Where have I heard it before? No, but really, I love discovering stuff like that. I mean, his power level must be over 9000!
Inugami is a dog-like ghost that could be summoned in order to execute revenge, and its origins involve cutting off a dog's head.
Please don't do that though.
Futakuchi Onna is the inspiration behind the Mawile Pokemon. It's a woman who's got a second mouth in the back of her head.
No thanks.
Jorogumo is a huge spider that can transform into a beautiful woman.
It just makes me not want to go to Japan anymore.
Okay, next up we have Daidarabochi, a yokai so huge he could create multiple lakes just by taking one step and even could pose as a mountain.
Oh my god! The games!
Donotsura is a yokai without a head, instead having a face on his... its torso. Supposedly, its name comes from a Japanese saying Donotsura Sagete, which literally means to lower one's face. And its idiomatic meaning is used when a person is weirdly calm when they should be ashamed of themselves. Akamanto is a guy who wears a red cloak and goes to toilets asking people if they want red, or blue toilet paper.
Yeah, now guess what the right answer is. If you chose red, you dead boy. And if you chose blue, congrats, you also dead boy. The correct one is neither. What?
Bakeneko is a cat-like yokai. This one only has one tail. There are many folk tales about them and other cat-like creatures, including one Bakeneko saving the Nabeshima family. Baku are monsters which devour nightmares.
Now that's practical. How much for one?
Jinmenju is a tree with human heads for flowers or fruits. Ugh. Kasa Obake are one or two-legged alive umbrellas that just like to mess with people for fun. Oni are big, ogre-like monsters in surprisingly vibrant colors, very popular in art and media. Rokurokubi are yokai whose neck can stretch out pretty much infinitely. So basically, ancient Elastigirl. And Kitsune are super powerful foxes and their abilities evolve as they get older. So basically like Pokemon.
But also in the Japanese mythology, all foxes are supposed to be able to turn into a human form. Damn. That's sly.
Oh, and that's fun actually. Some of you may already know that the word kamikaze means divine wind and was given to the two typhoons that supposedly saved Japan from the Mongols in the 13th century.
Man, I love etymology. And this fun fact concludes our short list of important divine beings. Sort of divine. What you just saw was the first entry to a new series of exploring various mythologies from all over the world. Of course, I wasn't able to fit everything I wanted in just those few minutes, but I hope I gave you some inspiration. That was my true goal. If you want to see more of these, you can subscribe or become a member to see the longer director's cut of this video and others in the future. But most importantly, just thank you for being here.